All of the titles in this trailer are written over these graphics that resemble the Rorschach test, which is used by psychologists to make determinations on their patients based on what they think they see first in the inkblots. If you want to hear about the secret images hidden in these inkblots, then stick around to the end of this video. It's a Decemberween miracle! We've got a new horror trailer on Decemberween. What a generous gift from Peele. Bring it in, Peele. Bring it in. Alright, so this trailer starts off with the family in the car, going to the beach, listening to the song, I Got Five on It. The kid asks what this means, and the daughter tells him it's about drugs. But then the father tells him,
it's not about drugs, it's a dope song, don't do drugs.
Now I'm not really an aficionado on hip-hop, unless we're talking about lo-fi, so I had to look this one up, and according to my research, he's a liar. The dad lied to his son about the meaning of this song. But one of the things we've all been wondering about Us before the trailer came out was if this one's gonna be more of a straight horror flick or lean more towards comedy. And it looks to be more on the serious side. You've even got the son wearing a Jaws shirt. And not only that, but wearing it to the beach. He's also got this Wolfman mask. I think that's what it is. And the girl that we meet later is wearing a Michael Jackson Thriller t-shirt, which of course has a music video known for a depiction of a werewolf movie at the beginning. Or maybe it's most known for spawning this meme now, but hopefully not. So the son wanders off the beach and encounters a spooky guy who's T-posing. Dude, you don't need to be T-posing, you already have blood on your hands. But that's actually not the only point in the trailer that this happens, because the son of the clone family is also seen doing it. See? Even horror villains can do it for the memes sometimes. These doppelgangers of the original family take over the house, and they appear to be evil versions of the main characters. But in addition to this family, there's also a duplicate of this little girl. This boat towards the beginning of the trailer is not the same one seen later on in the dark, and when they're initially walking to the beach, their long shadows represent a dark version of themselves. Since they have a dark version of themselves, they may also be the next hit Nintendo franchise. In fact, if you pause at 1 minute and 53 seconds into the trailer, you can clearly see Mario is standing there, holding hands with one of the doppelgangers. This one's called Scissors Mario. The handholding is also seen in this classroom scene, with a bunch of stick figures holding hands on the chalkboard. The handprints here below the chalkboard are reminiscent of a kindergarten art project type of thing, but in this case, they're all red, a reminder of the bloody-handed T-posing guy from before. We get it, dude. We get it. The other notable thing for me in this shot is the woman holding these cutouts up like bunny ears. There are a lot of references to magic in this trailer. Rabbits are usually associated with magic because magicians are always trying to pull a rabbit out of their hat for some reason. The daughter's got a rabbit on her shirt at the lake. The doppelganger son sits like a rabbit. There's a hall full of rabbits and a fight that takes place in a room of caged rabbits. The title card has a Rorschach test where the middle white part looks like a rabbit's face looking straight at you. We'll come back to the rest of this though. Another possible reason for all the rabbits, other than the magic reference, is that rabbits are known to quickly reproduce, and the antagonists of this movie seem to be reproductions of the main family. When the son wanders off, he goes towards an attraction called Merlin's Forest. There's also a painting of a fox on the side of the building, a natural predator of rabbits, and in this scene in the closet, there's a board game called Magic. So those are the definite magic references, and then there's also a shot here of the daughter on this cracked mirror, which makes me think of people sometimes referring to magic tricks as smoke and mirrors. But the mirrors could also have a different meaning, since the doppelgangers are like mirror images of the original characters. And that's where I'm gonna get into the inkblot stuff. Most of them are mirrored down the center. I think this one looks like the son's Wolfman mask a little bit. Maybe a little bit more like Chewbacca, actually, but they're pretty close. In this one, I see a skull. And in this one, I'm getting a creepy pair of eyes with a mask. Maybe a little Sub-Zero going on there. The final title card is the most interesting. I pointed out the rabbit already, but this could also be interpreted as the handle of the scissors seen throughout the trailer and poster. Then there are two faces looking outward, but this is the only title graphic that doesn't have perfect symmetry. Let me know what you saw in each of those Rorschach tests though, those are always interesting to hear what people saw. Wait, hold on, I think I see something. Yes, it appears to say, subscribe to CZsWorld for new horrors every week, ring that death bell for notifications, and I'll see you in the next one. Assuming we both survive.